Hello everyone, welcome to Insecta channel. So today we will discuss about the insect pest of cotton part 2. So already in part 1 we have discussed about the bollworm complex, what are the bollworms, and today we will discuss about the sucking pest of cotton. So cotton, it is having the sucking pests are like leafhopper, cotton, aphid, then white fly, mealybug, thrips, red cotton bug and stainer. This red cotton bug and stainer, these are again coming under the stainer category. Dusky and red cotton bug, these two are coming under the stainer category. So one by one we'll discuss. First is leafhopper, that is Amarasca bigutula bigutula. So it is coming under the trinomial nomenclature, that's why the scientific name is like this, Amarasca bigutula bigutula. Then distribution, you will find all over the India wherever you are growing the cotton. And apart from the cotton, they will also infest like in okra, potato, brinjal, castor, tomato. Then marks of identification, how you will mark, you can see this is the adult and this is the nymph. Adult is having green color with two black dot on the forewings apical, in the apical region, okay. Whereas nymph, you can see nymphs are pale yellowish in color. Then life cycle, so they will also, these are the eggs, so they will lay the egg singly on the leaf vein, okay. Then means on the leaf only they will lay the egg, okay. So egg laying capacity is more than 20 and the incubation period is 4 to 11 days. Then nymphal period is 7 to 21 days, total life cycle is 15 to 45 days. So we'll see the nature of damage. Here both the adult as well as nymph, they will suck the sap from the lower surface of the leaf. Always remember, they will suck the sap from the lower surface of the leaf, okay. So as a result, what will happen? See, always remember that if the sucking pests are attacking, the major nature is they will suck the sap, and wherever they are sucking, that part may get dry, yellow in color, changes will occur. Or if they are sucking the sap from the stem will get wilted. So these are the common thing you have to remember, okay. No need to mug off, just try to remember this thing, okay. So what will happen if they are sucking the sap? So leaves will turn yellow, leaf margin will curl downward. Sometime in like JRF question they will ask, or in semester exam also you will find curling upward, curling downward, curling inward. This kind of symptoms is which insect will cause this kind of symptom. So remember that cotton jacid or the leaf hopper, they will curl downward. So suppose this is the leaf, so leaf margin will curl downward, okay. Then the leaf will become, at the first the leaf will become yellow color, later it will changes to reddish color after drying. And as it is changing to reddish color, it will look like burnt, the plant is completely burnt, it will look like that, okay. So this is also known as hopper burn. So in cotton, hopper burn is caused by the jacid, okay. Next, the infestation occur in seedling stage and seedling gets killed and the number of flowers and bowls are reduced, okay. So you can see leaf margin, it will started curling downward. Here is the nymph and adults present on the underside of the leaf, lower portion of the leaf. Then we'll see about the aphid, okay. So scientific name of aphid is Aphis gossypii. So it is also distributed worldwide, polyphagous in nature, and also they will infest bhindi, brinjal, chili, amaranthus, okay. So how you will identify? Aphids are very small and pear shaped. Have you seen pear fruit like this? So you can see this is a pear shaped, okay. So small pear shaped, soft yellowish green or greenish brown in color, okay. So they are characterized by the presence of two tube like structure called cornicles. As you can see, these are the cornicles, this black color, two tube like structure, it is present in the abdominal region, fifth and sixth abdominal segment. So this is known as cornicles, and you will easily identify by seeing the cornicle, okay. So nymphs are small yellowish or brownish, and they will stay under surface of the leaf. As the jacid, they were staying under surface of the leaf, aphid will also stay under surface of the leaf, okay. And the terminal shoot, okay. So they will also live in the terminal shoot, and aphids found in cotton are mostly wingless, okay. Next we'll see the life cycle. So they are parthenogenetic and viviparous in nature. So viviparous means they will not lay the egg, okay. So directly they will give birth to the young one, okay. Then parthenogenetic female give rise to ovoviviparous female. So this thing will already discussed in the like morphology classes, so you can see what is ovoviviparous from there. Then single female may produce 8 to 22 nymphs per day, okay, and the nymphal period is 7 to 9 days. Then how this aphid will cause the damage? They will suck the sap, like leaf hopper were sucking the sap, this aphid will also suck the sap from the lower surface of the leaf. Then here also downward crumpling will occur, then faded the plant or the portion wherever they are sucking the sap, that area will fade, dried, and the plant become stunted. Finally, death of the plant. As you can see, the leaves are curling downward and the growth is not happening. So stunted growth will occur and finally death will happen, okay. So what is the difference between this leaf hopper and aphid? Very simple. In leaf hopper, burnt appearance will be there. If aphid is causing damage, you will not find burnt appearance, okay. Then leaves appear shiny and sticky due to honeydew secretion. So you all know that this sucking insect, they are releasing the honeydew. So due to this honeydew, the leaf will shine, okay. So honeydew will attract the ant, then later what will happen, on that honeydew fungus will grow, black fungus will grow, that is known as sooty mold, okay. So during ball opening stage, contamination of lint with honeydew will also occur. Sometime what will happen, this honeydew will be there on the plant surface or on flower or everywhere it will be there. So what will happen in ball opening time, cotton will also, you can see the cotton, okay. So that time this honeydew will contaminated with the cotton and they will reduce the quality of the cotton, okay. As you can see here also honeydew is there, and on that honeydew black sooty mold growth is occurred. You can see on the leaf also, whole plant on the bowls, okay. Then white fly, the scientific name is Bemisia tabaki. So it is also distributed worldwide. It is also a polyphagous pest, also attacking to the bhindi, potato, tomato, okay. So how you will identify this? These are minute with yellow body, you can see yellow body, but wings are white in color, okay. Then eggs are yellowish white, laid singly and under surface of the leaf. So here also you will find they are laying the egg under surface of the leaf, okay. Then nymphal, you can see greenish yellow or oval outline. This is the nymph, this is the egg, and this is the adult, okay. Then life cycle. So here the aphid, this white fly, they will lay the egg singly and stalked egg. What is the meaning of stalked egg? See, suppose this is the leaf, okay. So suppose this is the leaf surface, they will produce one stalk, then they will lay the egg. This kind of egg is known as stalked egg, okay. So you will find lower surface of the leaf, and each female will lay 120 eggs. Incubation period is 3 to 5 days, okay. And nymphs of this white fly, first instar nymphs are very active and highly mobile, so they are known as crawlers. Remember, crawlers is the first instar nymph and they are very active, okay. They are greenish yellow in color, and second and third instar are flat, scale like and immobile. So second and third instar of the aphid will be immobile, okay. First instar active and they are highly mobile. After the fourth molt, they will stop feeding and what will happen after the fourth molt, the nymph will not feed, okay. The nymph will stop feeding, so they will act like they are in pupal stage. So is means we are saying this as a pseudo pupal stage. So the white fly are having pseudo pupal stage. Actually the white fly, it is coming under the hemimetabolous insect. That means they will be not having pupal stages, right? Incomplete metamorphosis. But these white fly are having pseudo pupal stage as because the fourth molt is acting like a pupa. Means after fourth molt, the nymphal stage, fourth nymphal stage is acting like pupa. Okay, that's why these are having pseudo pupal stage. Very important question. In GRF also you will get this question, like pseudo pupal stage is found in dash, or like related to the pseudo pupal you will get one question. Okay, then total life cycle is 40 to 50 days. Then how they will cause the damage, this white fly? First, the adult and nymph, they will insert their stylets under surface of the leaf. Okay, so here also they will start feeding from the lower surface of the leaf. They will suck the sap. If they are sucking the sap, what will happen? The vitality of the plant and plant growth is stopped. Okay, so here also the growth of the plant will not occur and the buds will started shedding. Okay, and bad opening of the balls will occur. Okay, so prematurely the buds will start shedding and opening of the balls will occur, means bad ball opening will occur and quality of the lint will also decrease. Then they will also excrete the honeydew. So this honeydew, again this sooty molt will grow. Then it will, very important question, that it will also transmit a disease, that is leaf curl virus. Leaf curl virus of cotton is transmitted by white fly. Okay, you remember this, leaf curl virus of cotton is transmitted by white fly. Next is, see, this is the damage symptom. You can see these are the white fly, like this it will look in the field condition. So white chlorotic spot will appear on the leaf. Okay, then that white chlorotic spot, later it will join and form a irregular patches. Then yellowing of leaf will occur. Leaf will curl upward. Okay, so where we have studied that leaf will curl downward, in the leaf hopper. But in case of this white fly, the leaf will curl upward. Okay, always remember white up. Okay, white means up. So white fly upward curly. Okay, then plant vigor will reduce, that we already know. Then we'll see about the thrips. So thrips is the scientific name of cotton thrips, is thrips tabaki, and they are also distributed all over the India wherever you are growing the cotton. And also they are having different host like cabbage, cauliflower, then potato, tomato, radish, garlic and onion. Okay, so how you will identify? They are very small, slender, yellowish to brown color with fringed wings, and nymphs are very minute, slender, yellowish and microscopic in nature. Nymphs are microscopic, remember. Okay, so life cycle, the adult female, they will live for 2 to 4 weeks and they will lay egg 50 to 60 in kidney shaped. As you can see, this is the kidney shaped egg. Then they will lay singly by splitting the leaf tissue. Okay, they will insert their egg in the leaf tissue. Then egg period is 4 to 9 days, nymphal period 4 to 6 days, pre-pupal and pupal period is 1 to 2 days and 2 to 4 days. So these are also having pre-pupal and pupal period. Okay, they will pupate in the soil. So nature of damage, nymphs and adults, they will lacerate the tissue. Always remember, lacerating is a kind of sucking the sap only in case of the thrips. Okay, so they will lacerate the tissue under surface of the leaf, and also they will suck the sap from the leaves. And here also the leaf will curl upward. So in white fly also leaf was curling upward. In case of thrips also leaf was curling upward. Okay, and in aphid the leaf will curl downward, as well as in leaf hopper the leaf will curl downward. You remember this thing, upward white fly and thrips, downward downward aphid and leaf hopper. Okay, then silvery patches you will see. So thrips means, always remember, if you are writing silvery patches on the leaf or silvering of the leaf, silvery leaf will occur, that means it is only the damage symptom of thrips. Okay, if it is in case of rice or in case of any plant, if you are writing that silvery leaf, it is caused by that, this type of damage symptom is caused by thrips. Okay, so if you are not writing this also, curling upward downward, it is okay, but this silvery patches you have to remember. Okay, so you will find the silvery patches on the lower surface in the early stages, then brown color in the upper stages in the advanced stage. Okay, and the leaf edges will be broken and the plant will look like very sick. Okay, from the appearance, sickly appearance of the plant will occur. As you can see this leaf, this is the silvery appearance. Then management, how we will manage all this sucking pest. Okay, so dusky cotton bug and red cotton bug we will discuss in the stainer group. So now we have discussed the four sucking pests and how we will manage them, that we will discuss. Okay, first is you have to maintain early sowing, then closure spacing of the cotton will reduce the pest population of leaf hopper. Okay, so if you are giving closure spacing to the cotton crop, then the leaf hopper incidence will decrease. Okay, then you have to avoid the high dose of nitrogen, then you can install the yellow sticky trap, then you can set up the light trap. Okay, you can sow the cowpea with the rows and maize in the border. Okay, in between the rows you can sow the cowpea and maize in the border, then you can treat the seed with carbofuran, imidacloprid, thiomethoxam, anyone. Okay, anyone you can treat, then you can set application, means you can, if the seed is not treated with insecticide, you can use the imidacloprid. Okay, suppose you have not treated the seed, then you can spray the imidacloprid in the plant, then you can release the predator like Chrysoparla carnea. Then foliar spray, you have to see the ETL level, then only you can spray the foliar spray of neem pesticide. Then you can also apply acetamiprid, acephate. Okay, so among this only one chemical you can use, only one. Then mealybug, Phenococcus solanopsis. So mealybug, they are also distributed widely, so I think all of you know how the mealybugs will look like. So we'll see the nature of damage directly. So they will suck the sap from all the plant parts. Okay, and they will weaken the plant, and wherever they are sucking means that plant part will become very weak. Then the shoot tips develop a bushy appearance and the entire plant may become stunted. Okay, so wherever they are growing, that wherever they are feeding means that part will not grow and the tips will look like bushy appearance and the plant will become stunted, that means growth will not occur. Okay, then in affected plant bowls are few in numbers, deformed and small in size. Wherever they are affecting, that plant will have very few number of bowls, then and that bowls also deformed and small in size, then you will find this honeydew, sooty mold and ants will be there. Okay, next how you will manage this. So maximum is you can do this early cropping, then you can grow some intercropping or border cropping. You have to remove the alternate host. Okay, then the thing you have to write here, important one is you can use this Cryptolemus montrugeri, because it has successfully controlled the mealybug, so you can release the Cryptolemus montrugeri, or you can spray the biopesticide like Verticillium lichani or Bovaria vasiana, and chemical acephate, chloropyrifos, anyone you can apply. So thank you. Next class we'll discuss about the cotton stainer.